playoffs.
It's gonna be challenging.
Gotta win the first one, so all our focus is on this game. Got quite a challenge. I think the Green Bay Packers defense may very well be playing their best defense of the year. Look at the Giants and Chicago being the last two games. They played lights out. They've got excellent talent across the board. Very good inside. Very good at the linebackers. 21 Wilson is one of the best in the game. Back there in the secondary, both in coverage and he plays inside and nickel and as well as a tackler and a blitzer. And so we've got quite a challenge here. Great opportunity and quite exciting. We'll open up to questions.
Marty, Michael Vick spoke yesterday about his leg injury that he suffered in the Minnesota game. It sounded like it was worse than he kind of let on originally. He said he was playing on one leg. How much do you think that had to do with his inability to escape pressure and trouble in the pocket?
Well, certainly he wasn't 100% for the game. However, we can look for a lot of reasons why we didn't play on that game. We just got to play better. We left some details on the field. So whether he's not quite 100, our offense still has to put some points.
Marty, years ago, offensive coordinators used to say that they had to be aware of where Lawrence Taylor was on every single snap. In a game like this, do you have to be aware of Clay Matthews?
Yeah, 52 and 21, both of them. Those are two of the very best players in the game on defense. You have to be aware of where those two are every snap. Now, they have other excellent players as well. 90 and 77 are... 77's coming back from injury. 90's playing at a high level. So there's other players as well, but that's a good point, and we need to know where those two players are every snap.
Marty, the Packers have had a number of injuries since that first game.
Yeah.
Did you notice that they do anything schematically differently?
Yeah. Well, they've evolved just a little bit. However, the point is that they've done a heck of a job with some injuries, and they're the number two team in giving up points this whole year. So they've done a heck of a job on playing through injuries, and every team evolves just a little bit, depending on their personnel and depending on the things that they do best. So they have evolved just a little bit. Same scheme, very well coached. And the personnel that came in for those injured players is at a high level. They're very, very good players.
What are some of the characteristics historically with Don Capers' system? What do you get when you face it?
Well, now, that team has changed just a little bit because they're playing a lot of nickel. The old split six, so eight-man front. They've got good cover men with 21 down there, who's a very, very good tackler. So they sort of invite you to run the football to base type personnel groups. However, they're very good, and then if they get hurt just a little bit, they'll jump. Even against Chicago, they did it that way, and then they'll jump into 3-4 if they think that you're hurting with the run just a little bit. Don Capers is a fire zone 3-4 personnel based guy that has had great success with this scheme, and he's got players that fit each position within that scheme pretty well as well.
Have you spent much time talking about the new overtime rule with all of your guys?
Yeah, spent a little bit of time on that, yeah. It's probably going to be a rare, but there will be some decisions. Within those first couple possessions there. The first possession of each team, because the statistics and numbers show you one thing and sort of goes away from your gut instincts, just as a coach. So those will be some critical decisions there.
Do you think it is a more fair system?
Oh, I haven't sat back and looked at the big picture. I thought that our system as is very good. I really do. The one thing, you could debate that for quite a little while. I think we could discuss that and the positives and negatives to doing it both ways. So, you know, but the key, that first possession for each team, you know, you get into a fourth and one or fourth and two down inside the 10 or the 5, you know, there's your decisions there. And even further, you know, the numbers show you even further. So, you know, and as a coach, typically you're saying put the points on the board, you know. So, and then the odds and the numbers that have been accumulated over the years say something a little bit different. So.
Do you think Marty, that's how you would lean right now, facing that scenario?
Yeah. Well, not necessarily. Not necessarily. You try to put your team in the best position to win the game, you know.
Marty, talking to some of the players this past week, they were saying that they thought they had the protection schemes all down, and the biggest problems came from zero blitzes where they just set one extra guy. What happens in that situation? Do you have to pick up the is that the quarterback's?
Oh, we've been good against full plus one. You know, we had two or three problems with little disguise and really five man. It ends up being a five man rush. That's where we've had a couple of problems. I think we'll be in good shape there.